cool. You're happening. I noticed your belt. I hope I'm not embarrassing you by asking you about it. Now, look at this belt. Can you get a close-up of that? Look at this belt.
Wait a minute. It's a necktie.
Is that a... You wearing a necktie for your belt?
Yeah.
Really?
I forgot to bring a belt, so I... But I've done that down through the years. It works pretty good. You just tie a knot over here and cut off the end. I cut off the other end.
Yeah.
Is that like a Windsor knot over there that you're...
No, it's like in my shoes.
kind of like a samurai warrior or something, you know,
that's
with a sash.
That's pretty belt, though, you know.
That's very, very lovely.
It matches my shirt.
Mm-hmm. And I like, you know, I was going to say, I like the denim look with the suit. Are you fashion conscious?
No, I'm not. Somebody told me, said, you shouldn't wear that with a suit. And I started home to get some more trousers, and the traffic was so bad, I said, I'll wear what I brought.
Hey, I think you've started a new trend there.
That's right.
Hey, very important question here from an audience member, and I don't know if you get asked this a lot. You may. Larry Shaw is here from Oklahoma. Wants to know, do you do anything special to your fingernails for playing guitar?
I've been, somebody saw me on the television, and I was telling about having trouble with my nails, and they sent me some stuff that I rub on there, and said in 2 or 3 weeks it should help my nails, but my nails are too weak, and in the wintertime they break all the time, so I wear a glove, and I've done that since before Michael Jackson was born, you know, one glove on this hand to keep from breaking my nails in the wintertime, and I do have to watch it, because if I break a nail, got to cancel a show. You know, I can't play without nails.
Well, hey, that's right. That's terrible to think of.
You cancel a show because of a broken nail?
No, I couldn't. I couldn't play the solos, no.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we know they could put fake nails on.
Now, what I do, well, if it breaks off right down to the quick, though, it's tough. But what I do, if it breaks just a little bit, I take ping pong balls and just cut a little piece out and put it under your nail and glue it on. Mm-hmm. And ping pong ball is the right hardness and everything. They're just like your nails.
Well, I tell you, between your wardrobe and your picking, you're a mess.
And I tell you, in his latest video, he got pushed around by some little kid.
That's what I hear. This is the one you did with Jerry Reed?
Mm-hmm. Called The Claw.
The Claw, yeah. We had some little kids as director and everything. It's real cute.
Yeah, we have a clip, I think. And this is so funny to watch this man, a legend, get pushed around by some little kids. But it was supposed to be that way. Watch this.
That brings me around to what I was mentioning in the beginning. You know, this video that you have out teaching people how to play the guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Have people actually come back to you and say, "Here's what I've learned picking"? I mean,
it's for beginners. It's right down your.
Well, I'm a beginner. Yeah, I'm a beginner when it comes to that.
Yeah, I'll get you one of those.
But I mean, can you actually tune the guitar with it and all that?
Yeah,
because I don't know how to do that.
Shows you how to tune and all that. Yeah, it's. And there's two cute kids on there with me, too.
Oh, good.
Yes.
All right.
Well, now, when you think about this, now, this may be impossible, but you've influenced so many people who just listen to your records and so many people through the instructional video. If you had to guess how many people you started in playing guitars, could you even begin to find a number?
Oh, I don't know. I influenced a lot of people, I think, that could already play, probably.
Mm-hmm.
And they maybe decided to take up finger picking because I was one of the first ones to do that, you know, and they hear it and like what they hear and maybe do that. But I don't know how many people I've started playing. I hope a few. I run into rock and rollers every once in a while. Say, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be playing guitar. Go to hell or something. Stuff like that.